Oh, come on. We're right back where we started. Hello again, everyone. It's Dan, the Video Ninja. Welcome back to the Den of the Video Ninja for another entry in my reaction video series, in which I am going day by day through an episode per day of the BBC anthology series known as Inside Number 9. This was a show that was on 5 or 6 years ago. It's an anthology show. Every episode is a different little short story that plays out. Most of them are kind of these weird, twisty, Twilight Zone-y type episodes, but instead of like the surrealism of Twilight Zone or the, like the big gut punch at the end of the episodes, they're more focused on being humorous, usually in a dark tone of humor or a naughty tone of humor, and they do sometimes come with a twist ending or a gut punch ending. Throughout the month, I've been watching episode after episode and, you know, trying to get a sense of each episode and maybe see if I can second guess where the narrative is going to go, but mostly just been enjoying how good the writing is episode to episode, how much they change up the formats of all these episodes, and they're just really cool stories, I think, and I kind of dig how they can be these little neat little yarns that are written out, and they keep you guessing a little bit, and I'm enjoying that. If you want to see these episodes yourselves, I believe they're available somehow through Amazon, so maybe check that out, and maybe watch the episodes first before enjoying my content, because obviously I'm giving you guys like a little blitz of highlights and everything, but I am going to be showing parts of the show and probably the good spoilery parts. So if you don't want the show spoiled for you, I recommend that you watch the episodes first, because this is a show that really benefits from not knowing anything about the episodes going into them, hence why I enjoy doing the reaction videos for them. So with that said, we're going to dive into episode 2 of season 3. I forgot where we were at this point. Entitled The Bill. Number 9 is the name of the restaurant. I'm loving that they're keeping that going.
And I had Mashy Niblick at 50 to 1.
Here you see, clever boy, back the outsider.
Exactly.
I'm sorry, are we in a Tarantino film? This is just rapid-fire dialogue around in a dinner scene.
So come on in, what happening?
There's something off about this conversation, but I can't put my finger on it yet. Also, where's the bill?
You know, the palate.
So this is all just, like, wordplay and misunderstandings. That's what this entire conversation is built on.
Giving them my tip.
What are you doing asking for
business? Men.
Remove the ring and boom, your ass is gone.
Men.
Jesus Christ, go on then.
Don't joke, I'm joking. No.
Yes.
That's this whole episode. It's just them arguing over who's going to get the bill, right?
You just get this little starter.
This is just going to erupt into like a fist fight at some point. And then
to the company provided, notice what's in your belly.
These guys are just rapid fire with this dialogue. It's kind of amazing. Oh, here we go again. This poor waitress. She's going to end up, like, shooting them all.
If you're paying for dinner, you're paying for dinner.
I can't believe they're going to stretch this into a whole half-hour argument over the fucking bill. This is fantastic. Oh, good grief. Here we go.
I'll be back.
This poor lady just wants to go home, and these guys are going to keep her there all night until she freaks out and just blows their heads off.
It was anonymous. You were seen Kevin a Garfunkel's lunch every day for a fortnight.
I can't keep up with this conversation. This is insane.
I'm offering to buy everyone's meal.
Yes, because you're a selfish prick.
What? What just happened? If I was this waitress, I would just kick them out at this point. Fuck it.
It's fine. It's fine. It's fine.
It's not fine. This is ludicrous.
I've got a brain tumor.
Where did that come from?
Allowing me to pay that bill.
Here we go. Back to this again.
I can't take much more of this.
Neither can I.
We're going to sort this once and for all.
Oh, come on.
What is he doing, Archie?
What the hell is going on now?
Four, five,
oh, God, I can't stand watching six, people play this stupid thing. Oh, my God. Oh, God. This is so suspenseful, man. It's just been escalating and escalating! Oh God! Oh ma'am! Holy shit!
What? Archie,
just
what should I do?
Happened!
Call the police. The less you know about it, the better.
What?
How much does he want?
200.
Oh, that's actually very reasonable.
Oh, come on. We're right back where we started. Oh, you got to be kidding me. This has all been a ruse to get into his safe? Are you fucking kidding me?
I told you it was too elaborate.
It's going fine.
That was going fine? Oh, no. They're actually going to go after him now, aren't they? Holy crap. You're screwed, buddy.
Can we get the bill, please?
Certainly, sir. Won't be a second.
Interesting. Now he's the waiter. What? Oh my god, that episode was a journey. I don't know how to describe it, but for some reason, that episode felt like it was twice as long as any of the other episodes in this series I've watched. Because that one was a prime example of what I've been talking about with this twisty narrative gymnastics that these episodes go through. Because that started off as this rapid fire, escalating, hilarious argument about the bill that was just going to escalate into like a scuffle or whatever. And, you know, that was the first part. And then it just tonally shifted into like this murder cover-up. And then it tonally shifted again into this scam, but then it also had a button ending where they still jumped the guy they were trying to scam. Wow. I think the most admirable thing about that episode was definitely the performance by the four actors, because they were just going through those lines left, right, and center. And I get it. The object was to sort of disorient you off the bat by having this rapid-fire discussion that just escalated and bounced back and forth. But it really felt like the left turn when they got the knife out or whatever was such a huge left turn that it's just fantastic. I really don't know that that episode really needed that very, very last scene though, where the guy got turned into the waiter. I think it could have just ended right there. But other than that, that episode was fantastic. Very impressive. I might have to just go back and watch it again, like right now, as soon as I finish this video, just to maybe get a second pass at things so I can keep up with it this time. 'Cause that was wild.